Upon its arrival yesterday, the P&O Pacific Jewel has already taken in some of the participants of the APEC summit. The cruise liner was chartered by Australia to assist in providing world-class accommodation and meeting venue for the major event. Minister for APEC, Justin Tachenko, said the Pacific Jewel will accommodate participants, including the international media. The media personnel alone is 2,000 plus.
And the first cruise ship has arrived, which is already taking on the participants of the CEO summit and of the APEC leaders' meetings as well. This boat will be filled from all the different economies, from the 21 leading economies of the world, on this boat particularly, as well as the media, will be also housed on the Pacific Jewel as well.
Carnival Australia, the cruise liner's company, has also chartered three other ships to assist PNG in providing accommodation for the APEC delegates. The two other P&O cruise ships, which are yet to arrive in Port Moresby in the coming days, include the Pacific Explorer as well as the Sea Princess.
This is the first cruise liner to arrive. The second one will be arriving in the next couple of days, which will host and hold on it the CEO summit. And then from there, the other one will follow day after and be parked at Motukia.
Meanwhile, the three ships will be stationed at the Fairfax Harbour and surrounding waters within the APEC maritime security zones. Participants, upon their arrival on the cruise ships, will be electronically registered through a unique face recognition system. Elizabeth Guka, National EMTV News.